High school playoffs heating up here in the state of Wisconsin. As the weather gets colder, the football gets hotter. Along with Eric, I'm Rich. The Supercharged Foods WIAA Football Roundup takes us through level two of the high school football playoffs. And what was a bit of a downer last week in level one for a lot of local teams, level two was kind of a redemption week for a lot of local teams, as we saw a lot of local teams get wins.
Right, and at this point in the season, you're seeing a lot of those number one seeds drop out of the race. And for most of the cases, that wasn't the case this week. So interestingly enough, a lot of one seeds we got. Obviously, Homestead, Wanakee on there, still surviving right now. So those are some interesting teams to look out for.
Yeah.
As we get further into this thing.
And a team that's going to be going up against the number one seed, the Sun Prairie Cardinals, have now won 10 football games in a row.
Yeah.
They pull away with a 24-0 second half against Sussex Hamilton. And how about Nate Schauer? He goes off. Three touchdown runs for him. And, oh, Cooper Nelson sighting as well. Seven catches, 90 yards for him in that Sun Prairie win.
Yeah, he still was kind of in and out of that ball game, so still sort of dealing with the issue. Maybe it was a knee a couple weeks ago when we covered him. So we'll see kind of what his situation is moving forward. But that defense for Sun Prairie, I mean, they held, a second-half shutout, just two first downs, and a negative two offensive yards allowed in the second half.
Absolutely amazing.
Crazy.
Coach BK's got to be excited about that. If his defense shows up against Fond du Lac like that, that is going to be one heck of a football game. One football game that we are going to have on the air. Yeah, we could break the news right now.
Yes, let's do it.
On 57 Sports. Wanakee hosting Monona Grove should be outstanding. It almost didn't happen that way. It was almost Monona Grove hosting DeForest. DeForest came out to a 14-0 lead on Wanakee before the Warriors were able to come back.
Yeah, uncharacteristic for Wanakee to be down not once but twice in that ball game. They haven't trailed a game all season, so they finally had to face some adversity. They did end up coming out of that one. They get that late interception to seal the win. And I think that is the scare maybe Wanakee needed to say, we can't just be complacent as, you know, the, I don't want to say just hand them the trophy. And I think they kind of feel like that's not a given anymore. So now they're going to go against, as you said, Monona Grove. They're handling their things pretty well right now.
Monona
as well.
Monona Grove, no doubt, believe it or not, they were down 7-0 in that game to La Crosse Central. Oh, then they rattled off like 28 straight points. And Jordan,
527 yards of offense.
Wow, Jordan Bishop had a lot of it, had four touchdown passes in that game. I mean, holy cow. We love seeing Jordan Bishop. We're going to see him go up against a pretty good Wanakee defense.
Yeah, I was kind of looking at some of the you know, situations from in the past between those two teams, and they've played in the playoffs 9 times. This will be the 10th time they've met in the postseason, and Wanakee has had the edge. But Monona Grove firing in all cylinders, especially on offense right now.
Yeah, that should be one heck of a football game. Can't wait to bring everybody that one. Other local note here, the Watertown Goslings going down to a very good Homestead team and going down hard. That Gosling defense has struggled all year. No change in that one against Homestead.
Yeah, and that was Homestead just, they stuck with the run game and they kept going to it. Over 500 yards of rushing and 8 touchdowns. So just, Homestead's going to continue to do that, I imagine, as they keep moving forward here.
Yeah, that is a good football team. Other local scores of note, look at Mount Horeb Barneveld. I mean, absolutely wrecking Pewaukee. Malik Winston, 3 touchdowns.
You know, and I want to say we don't talk about Mount Horeb Barneveld enough, and sometimes we get on a point where we're talking about them, and sometimes we don't talk about them enough. But boy, the Vikings are good, 9-2, and they've rattled some things off, and just 2 losses right now. You're feeling pretty good about this team. Yes, they take on Catholic Memorial, who's the number one seed, and yes, they are typically there in the last few weeks of the season. But you got to feel pretty good about this team right now. Oh yeah, they have a first-year head coach.
Yeah, absolutely amazing. He's done a great job. Speaking of teams we don't talk about enough, and that's probably Edgerton and the Crimson Tide. Holy cow, they got a player at quarterback in Jaden Johnson, who was able to put up nearly 300 yards of offense, but 2 passing touchdowns, 3 rushing touchdowns going off, and a big win over Lodi. Lodi, by the way, the only defending champ to be knocked out so far in the playoffs.
Yeah, so unfortunate for them, they kind of stumbled into the postseason losing a couple of games, so that's why they ended up being a 6 seed and having to go on the road in this one. So maybe things would have been flipped, I don't know. Yes, Lodi does go down in Edgerton, a big win there, and taking on Lakeside Lutheran. So they're certainly in a position where you're feeling pretty good about what they're doing this year.
Absolutely. Another team of note here, Lancaster with a big win over Darlington, 42-6. doesn't get all the local teams in. We would be remiss if we didn't talk about the Cambridge Blue Jays as well, who, by the way, are undefeated and still moving along.
Yeah, so it's pretty crazy. We got some good teams in this area, and the lower divisions, don't want to forget about those guys.
Yeah, absolutely not. So again, I want to highlight the game that we're going to be doing. So MG at Wanakee. We've had a chance to see MG this year. We haven't seen Wanakee yet, so it's going to be our first look at them. Now, Alec Ogden, a couple of years ago, won off, got a big win on the road at Wanakee in the playoffs. What does Monona Grove need to do against Wanakee to win at Wanakee this time around?
Yeah, you can't make any mistakes. I mean, this Wanakee team, this defense is stout. They've been forcing a lot of turnovers. Their offense, we've seen them put up a lot of points this year. But Monona Grove, if you can continue to put your game plan out there and just don't make mistakes. By the way, the quarterback, Jordan Bishop, has just 2 interceptions this year with 26 touchdowns. So I'm not too concerned about him as a quarterback. But you gotta stay crisp and clean. So I'm just saying, limit those turnovers.
Turnovers can tell the tale in what should be the game of the year locally. A lot of people looking forward to that one, and we will be there. For Eric, I'm Rich. That is our report brought to us by Supercharged Foods.